Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to talk to you today about messages and AI work for desktop. We're at the interface for the message section in 8x8 Work. And if you click this icon here, this is the section for messages. Towards the top of the screen, you have a couple different options to choose for your different message types. You have all messages, which includes all one-on-one messages and room messages. If you click this tab here for one-on-one, these are individual text messages that you may have sent within your organization or out to other text-enabled numbers that can receive and send SMS messages. There's also a section here for rooms. So these are private rooms where you can have more than a couple people in here to collaborate and chat about different items within your organization. So we're going to go into further detail about what's going on. But if you've used any type of chat application or sent any type of text message, you should feel right at home with this messaging feature set in 8x8 Work for Desktop. We're in a section for one-on-one messages, and this lists all the text messages that you've sent either within your organization or out to other individuals that are outside of your phone system. By clicking on this entry here, I'm presented with the chat history and any messages, any attachments, or any pictures that have been included in this discussion. So for this individual user here, this is somebody that's outside of my phone system, and they've sent me some pictures for me to receive. So not only will I get this on the desktop app, but from the mobile app, I will also get access to the same messages and the same pictures or any other discussions that have been made with this individual contact. So that's one thing that I like about this particular cloud platform. So regardless of the device you're using, it's going to work and it's going to be there when you need it. So from here, I can click on the picture and it loads up and it shows me a little bit more detail about that image. I can download this image and then save this for offline use. Or I can do some other things like mark this as unread. If I do that, it tells me that I have an unread message here in this one-on-one section, as well as under the message section for 8x8 Work. So once again, go back here and it tells me that I have a new message that's unread. We're gonna jump over to another conversation. So I want you to understand with this is that this messaging functions not only as the SMS messaging that I'm talking about, but also as a chat. So depending upon who you're in conversation with, it'll switch between either the chat or an SMS function. So I'm gonna go here to one of my colleagues in the phone system, and you can see that this message history is just a little bit different from another one. So let's just say, for instance, I go down to this individual. You see that this individual has sent me this message, and then my message is in a completely different color. Now, if I go back to this conversation with Anita, you can see that all of our message history is in this dark gray and gray color, versus with an external contact, me sending that message out to that individual is in this green color versus another gray color. So just keep in mind, you're chatting with other individuals outside of your organization, it's a different color versus people within your organization, which is going to be the same color type of message. So if we go back to our original message, I'm just going to point out a couple areas up here towards the top. We can see the contacts. So I don't have this particular contact saved in my call logs, but I can call this individual by hovering over that and clicking that icon element to call them. I can click the three dots, which gives me more information, search. I can snooze this conversation or pull up additional contact information, or I can simply just close this out and then this conversation goes away. And here's a different conversation, and I want to bring to your attention, you have a couple more elements down here towards the bottom. So you have one section here for attachments. So let's just say, once again, if I'm chatting with a colleague within my organization, I want to send an attachment. I can click on that. Maybe I want to send a Word document or maybe a slide presentation or whatever it is, even a zip attachment. I can attach that directly to this message and then send this to my colleague on my phone system. There's also a section here for emojis, and then you can see here in this message box that I can type and send any message that I please. So I'm just going to show you what that looks like here today. So that message has been sent. You can see there's a timestamp down here showing when the message was sent. There's also an icon here to show that the individual has either seen your message or hasn't seen your message. So that's kind of good to know if you're wondering, whether or not your boss or supervisor or maybe an employee has gotten your messages. Just like we talked about in the call video for 8x8 Work, you can see present status up here towards the top. So we can see that Anita is green. So that means she's available on 8x8 Work. She has her current status. And then I can either call her, I can send her, or excuse me, I can meet with her right away if this is an important discussion that we need to talk about. And then there's some more options to search, snooze, or look at additional contact information. And if we click on additional contact information, we can see a little bit more info about who Anita is in your organization. And that is pretty much it for the contact section for messages. Once again, if I'm done with this conversation, I can click this X to exit out altogether. So I'll show you real quick what attachments look like. We're going to click this attachment file and we're going to look for something to add. Click that. And then you see that the attachment is now here. And then I can add a caption to this. And then I can click this send to send that. And then now that attachment has been sent, and Anita can now click on that. She'll see it on her end and she gets the attachment. So pretty easy with how that works. Let's just say that for whatever reason, I messed something up and I didn't want that to be sent. I can go here to edit the message and, change the contents of the message. We're just going to exit out of that. Or let's just say that I want to delete it altogether. So go ahead, click on delete, select the message, and that message is now deleted. So with that being deleted, it shows up on Anita's end. Just let her know that that message is no longer available. But if you do mess up, you can certainly delete messages, and it allows you to kind of save face if you need to, if you end up sending the wrong attachment or the wrong information to the wrong person. Another thing I just want to highlight again too is message history. So once again, anytime that I send messages to anybody from my 8x8 work number, that is saved in the cloud and it's available on any one of my devices. So once again, for the work desktop app, I'm able to look at that message history, as well as on my mobile device, I can see the same message history. And I can scroll back and go to different dates, and you see there's quite a bit of history here that's been saved between this conversation between me and my colleague. So once again, this is stuff that's preserved and it's saved. And if you are ever trying to figure out maybe, what was the last conversation that you had with maybe a customer or a colleague, this will help you and jog your memory about, what that conversation was. And one of the cool things that I like about this particular messaging app is that you can now use one unified phone number to give out to work colleagues, to customers, or whoever the case is. You no longer have to give out that cell phone. If you want to give this out as your only number, you can certainly do that and know that you can receive messages reliably, as well as send messages and receive pictures all along with keeping one number as the only number that people need to reach you at. And now we're going to take a look at rooms. So rooms is a form of group chat. So once again, let's just pretend that we're in the sales organization and we need to exchange information, exchange data, and we want to do this without maybe disturbing some of the colleagues in the service department. So I could literally create another room right now with sales individuals and then add them to this room. If I look into this room here, you can make your rooms either private or public. With a private room, you're only able to find this if you're actually invited to this room. And then once you're invited to the room, you can see all the contents of what was said in a room. There's a concept of a public room. So there's an all company here. This comes by default with 8x8 Work. And then all the individuals within your company have access to this public room. So this is good if you need to send an announcement, maybe to talk about what's going on with the company, or maybe even share some pertinent information. All this information can be seen by all employees. So you might want to just be careful about the information and the messages that you share here because anybody in the organization can see this. So if we go back here to just a couple different rooms that I've created, we can see here that this is the details of the room, the type of room this is. It's a private room, and then the members of this room. So if I wanted to add some additional members, I can look up people from within my organization and then have them added to that. So pretty neat. It's pretty similar if you've ever used with any other team function, any one of those services. This is built in into your cloud communications phone system setup, and it's all tied in to this experience. So if you are on the phone and if you're or maybe even busy in a meeting, you know, your present status, which we talked about in the previous video, that changes colors. So that lets you know, whether or not you're available to maybe take a message or if you're tied up and then you're busy in the meeting. So all around, it's a pretty clean and pretty easy messaging function that you can use for 8x8 Work for Desktop. And, you know, that's pretty much it. So if you have any questions, any concerns, or if you need any more assistance with this, let me know. Feel free to drop this in the chat. And once again, this is Jamal Abbott. Thanks for tuning in, and I will talk to you soon.